Thank you very much for inviting me in this special yoga day, in this absolutely rich and deep platform. Namaste to all divine souls. This year we celebrate the International Yoga Day in a very particular way, and the pandemic has brought suffering, separation, and global crisis. We must stay isolated, and we are far from one another, but we are united because interconnected by tools that help us to share, to reflect, and to search. So COVID-19 has shown us human and scientific fragility. It has also shown us how far our life is from nature, and we are in serious danger. In the world today, millions of people practice yoga. And in COVID era, we can understand even better how much yoga and Ayurveda can bring tremendous benefits for healthy and happy humanity. We all know that health is not only a physical factor, but this was already well known by the ancient rishis, the wise seers, as shown in the passage of Sushruta Samhita. I quoted, "One who is established in the self, who has balanced doshas, balanced agni, properly formed dhatus, proper elimination of malas, and whose mind, souls, and senses are happy, is called a healthy person." So I don't want to linger on the extraordinary means that yoga, pranayama, Ayurveda can give to the world. For this, we have scientists, doctors, yogis, and so on. And we share today a lot of knowledge on this. I wish to underline the importance in this materialistic world of the profound spiritual and philosophical consideration that yoga and tradition of Hindu Dharma offer us. Again, Ayurveda text shows us the importance of our ethics and morals for health and common good. In Charaka Samhita, Vimanasthana, chapter 3, verses 19-20, there is an amazing dialogue between Guru and his disciple. We find a description of a picture that is very similar to our times. It deals with pandemics and destruction of populations. Agnivesha puts a question to his guru, and he asks, which are the real factors of environmental degradation that lead to epidemic and wars? Lord Atreya replies that the root cause is adharma, the violation of natural law by human beings. The source of this adharma is intellectual error, prajna parada. Lord Atreya gives an astonishing answer. So here is the prescription that together with the medical therapies should accompany our moral and ethical conduct. I quoted, "Truthfulness, compassion for living beings, charity, sacrifice, worship of God, observance of right conduct, tranquility, protection of oneself, living in a healthy country, service and observing brahmacharya, study of religious scriptures, constant association with the good person and those who are approved by elders. All this, with the view of protection of life, has been termed the medicine." The concept of sarva bhuta hita is the highest ethical and should be applied according to the individual dharma. Is that a common good for all, such as the protection of environment, welfare of the poor and the needy, of the well-being of all living beings, comes before the personal good, including individual, material, and personal well-being. The future is in our hands, and the ancient science of yoga can enlighten us also through the deep ethical, philosophical, and spiritual perspective of sage Patanjali. In the Yoga Sutra, we find an amazing statement, Heyam Dukkham Anagatam. The future suffering must be avoided. So the goal of yoga is not to avoid the sorrow or free ourselves from it, but avoid the creation of new pain. We must understand the roots and meaning of suffering and fulfill Dharma through right and conscious living. So I finish with one mantra saying Om Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Sarve janaha sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. My time is finished. I bless you all.